Heather thinks about copyright.
This week, Red Hat announced a change to its policy about source code access, and the open source community is abuzz with Discord. What happened? The announcement said, CentOS Stream will now be the sole repository for public RHEL-related source code releases. For Red Hat customers and partners, source code will remain available via the Red Hat customer portal. That was an odd way to announce what happened, and it did not go over well. To understand the controversy, you need to understand about Red Hat and GPL licensing. Put simply, the GPL is the license that covers the Linux operating system. It's a special kind of license that makes you share source code if you distribute binaries. Software-like operating systems, Windows, macOS, and Linux, runs in executable form. That's the format of ones and zeros that the computer can understand. But it's written in source code form. That's the language used by programmers to write programs. The GPL is based on the idea that anyone who has executable code should also have the right to get the corresponding source code. That way, if you have the skills, you can study the source code, make changes to it, fix bugs, and share your improvements with others. That's free and open source software in a nutshell. Red Hat is the most successful commercial open source business on the planet. It sells subscriptions to its Linux build, which is called RHEL, or Red Hat Enterprise Linux. A few years ago, Red Hat was bought by IBM, a company with which it had had a close relationship for many years. It was a huge acquisition and generally thought to validate that open source development was a viable business. But since the acquisition, Red Hat has made a couple of big policy changes in its business, and both of them have caused consternation in the open source world. The first had to do with a version of Linux called CentOS. For many years, CentOS was like the non-commercial fraternal twin of RHEL. Most importantly, CentOS was downstream from RHEL. That meant that once updates made their way into CentOS, they were battle-tested. Many Linux developers used CentOS as the basis for their own products. For developers, downstream is good. In 2022, Red Hat announced that it would change CentOS to upstream and renamed it CentOS Stream. That left a lot of Linux developers scrambling because they didn't want to use an upstream and more untested version in their products. As is common in the open source world, as a result of that unpopular change, other developers moved in to provide substitutes for what CentOS used to be, including Rocky Linux, which was run by one of the original developers of CentOS, formerly at Red Hat. This week, Red Hat dropped an even bigger bombshell. It announced that it would no longer make its source code for RHEL available to anyone but its own customers. Put another way, CentOS Stream is now the only public repository for source code for RHEL, but of course it isn't exactly RHEL, it's more like a beta version of it. This caused another scramble in the industry. Originally, developers had drawn on CentOS for their source code. Then they had to switch to RHEL. At the time, each of those were the most downstream, reliable versions of the software. But now, only Red Hat customers have direct access to the source code for the downstream version. Some people have suggested this is a violation of GPL. To understand why, we need to delve into the mechanics of GPL. GPL is what's called a copyleft license. Some people call that viral, but that's not the right word. But it is accurate in one sense. The license terms stick to the software, no matter how many times it's redistributed. One of the requirements of the GPL is that if you give people executables, you have to offer them source code. But that doesn't mean you have to offer it to the whole world. In fact, many companies make their source code available behind the firewalls of their customer dashboards. There is a separate, more philosophical question about whether this is good for the Linux community. I'm a lawyer, so I don't really qualify to comment about ethics. But in the end, developers who drew on CentOS and now RHEL are feeling whipsawed, and the announcement by Red Hat is establishing a pattern of estranging the open source community. The open source community tends to have a narrative about big companies ruining open source communities when they buy open source projects, and unfortunately, the recent moves of Red Hat with CentOS and RHEL are doing nothing to contradict that view. I hope you enjoyed this tidbit. See you in the next video.
Heather thinks about copyright.